Light Orchestra and Living Thing. Now, my next guest, I think, has just got the best job ever. Well, it is if you're someone who loves animals and being in the countryside. Kerry Jordan from Frizzington in Cumbria, who runs Fur and Fables, is an award-winning commercial pet photographer. Her images are used by businesses to sell, well, whatever products it is that they're making, dog coats and collars, and she also does portraits of family pets as well. What a lovely job. Kerry, she's on the line with me now. So just explain then how you got into this job, because, you know, it's not an obvious business, is it, pet photography? It's not sort of, doesn't spring to mind. People kind of go hairdresser, I maybe want to be a vet or a police officer. I don't think so many go, I'd like to be a commercial pet photographer.
Yeah, it's I was exactly the same, actually. I was quite artistic at school, but it was never really pushed as a career choice. I was a PA in the city for a very, very long time.
Wow.
And I just kind of picked up a camera. It was a point and shoot probably about 15 years ago, and then sort of progressed to a very basic digital SLR. There's something just clicked for me. And I started taking portraits and things. I got into wedding photography because I thought that's what you had to do as a photographer to make money. And then I didn't like the long days, so I started doing family portraits. And then I got my own dog and started taking portraits of him. So when that happened, I think my whole life changed, basically, as soon as I started taking dog portraits. And people started commissioning me to do their own dogs. And then quite quickly, I got my first commercial client, who is still a client today, and that was about 8 or 9 years ago.
Hmm.
And it kind of grew organically. And then last year, I thought, I love helping pet brands like really elevate their products and services. And I pivoted, and it's just taken off hugely.
It's
pretty cool.
It does sound, Kerry, like you actually somehow managed to find a job that you absolutely love. Not quite by accident, but certainly, I don't know, like seeing pivoting is a smart thing to do. They say, don't they, though, don't work with children, don't work with animals. You know, how
I work with both.
Well, yeah, how bad has it got for you? Have there been sort of photo shoots that you've sort of maybe had to abandon, or have you always managed to sort of persevere with an unruly animal, say?
I think working with dogs has taught me, first of all, patience, which I never thought that I had. And second of all, it has taught me how to just adapt. One of the things that I've learned is that you just can't like set your mind on a particular setup. You have to work with the dogs and how they feel on the day, because there are some dogs who, you know, are usually perfectly good at sitting and waiting, and then one day decide that they're just not going to do it, so we have to change direction. But yeah, I've had dogs. There was one dog who I was photographing a very smart dog drying coat for, and he jumped in the lake with it on. Thankfully, we managed to get a few shots, but the clients that I work with are really, really cool, and they got some great outtake shots. And then the other ones are just like when I'm working with dog treats, there has been a few occasions where the dogs have just stolen the treats and were running around gleefully with them. So
I love this. What animal have you experienced being the most difficult to photograph when you get this sort of, when you get a particular job and you think, actually, this is going to take maybe more time and expertise than you'd thought initially?
I think that there's two. Cats are one. There are agencies who actually train cats for commercial pet shoots, but the ones that I've worked with have been very organic. And so that's one where you just have to go with them. Cats do their own thing. So, but we got the beautiful shots. And I think the other thing is when I'm working with anxious dogs, so one of the brands that I work for is called My Anxious Dog, and she raises awareness of anxious dogs with sort of yellow bows and yellow mm-hmm. leaves and things like yeah. that. And you have to be very aware that the dog doesn't like to be approached, and you know, you have to be very conscious of that and work around the dog to make sure it's really, really comfortable. So things like that. But generally, I think I've set myself up, I'm probably good some terrible shoots now, but I think I set myself up in a place where you know, it's kind of very easy to get the shoot done. We manage it really well, so far nothing too difficult.
Do you know what, Kerry? I think, listen to what you've said and having a bit of a think of it, I think with animals, because they obviously don't speak, I think they pick up on energy. And I think if you've got the right energy when you go into these things, I always find, see, I'm allergic to cats. So cats often approach me because I show them no interest. I think there's some sort of psychology where people go, oh, you're not allergic, are you? And then when I say, oh, yes, I am, they suddenly feel really apologetic, try and keep the cat away from me, which makes them fascinated with you because you've not attempted to pet them or even look at them. But I sort of subscribe to with animals. It's about a good energy, I guess, just to set them, I don't know, just to keep them in a good space when you're, I guess, trying to get the best out of them.
Yeah, absolutely. And as I said, I've worked with quite a lot of anxious dogs, and the way that I go into it, because I think I tried to tally it up. I've worked with well over 500 dogs over the last few years. And I think you get a feel for things. And I always try and ask my clients beforehand if they're anxious. And what I tend to do is, like you with the cat, I just ignore them for a little while, and then, you know, I'll get treats over the floor and things like that. And generally, the owners have a lot of the time been surprised because the dog then decides to clamber all over me while I'm trying to take portraits.
I love this.
But it is, you do have to have a certain element of actually watching the dog to pick up on its cues.
So what is next for you then, Kerry? Have you got some exciting stuff in the diary for this year?
I have. Well, I've just won a small business award from Dragon's Den CEO for Thesis.
Wow.
So I've just been to a big award ceremony in Birmingham to pick up my certificate, which was insane. It was just an absolute pleasure. And he really championed small businesses. And kind of on the back of that, I thought I really need to sort of create a little bit of a buzz around business. So I'm at the moment creating FOMO with a FOMO creator around Crust, which is next week. So I'm going to be going around and helping small businesses create content on their stands for free, because I really want to help. And then I also have National Dog Photography Day coming up in July, which is a day that I created and it goes viral. But this year I want to do something really big for charity.
Amazing.
So I'm creating some really cool stuff.
God, you are super busy. And what I love, Kerry, about your story is essentially that you found your way to it. I don't know, maybe the job and you found one another. It's brilliant. And congratulations on the award. It must be nice being recognised for doing something that you clearly enjoy.
Yeah, it was quite serendipitous, actually, because I tried to, you pitched to Theopathesis, and I pitched for years and years doing my private pet portraiture. And then I pitched two of my, one of my businesses that I help photograph for, a dog friendly cottage. They won the first time. And then my friend who also owns another dog friendly cottage, she pitched the 2 weeks after. She won with an image that I'd also taken for her. So I thought, right, I've got to go in. So I pitched for the first time as a commercial pet photographer and won first time as a commercial pet photographer. So I think it was quite serendipitous. And it was like all three of us within a month was absolutely amazing.
Oh, well, thank you for your time this morning, Kerry. I've really enjoyed our chat, and best of success with all the stuff you've got planned this year, because it sounds like there's absolutely no rest for you.
I know. It's already been a really good year. Thank you for having me on.
Oh, you're welcome.